You are watching DHTV, the television program service of California State University, Dominguez Hills.
evening to all of you out there in television land. Welcome to session number 9 of IDS 336. As always, you've tuned in to Jazz in the Modern Era. I'm Chet Hanley, and we are coming to you ever so live from the campus of California State University, Dominguez Hills, over LA 36 and all of those affiliates out there. And we are also coming to you via the internet. So we are all over the place. It's great to be back with you for another evening of music. You see a number, the same numbers you've seen throughout the semester, 800-339-1193 remains our number into our room here on the campus of Cal State Dominguez Hills. And you see an address where you can reach me via your computer and ask questions or make comments. And again, as always, we archive all of our broadcast sessions 1 through 8 are available to you at youtube.com/CSUDHTV. This particular session, session 9, will be available to you within about 24 hours. And another reminder that this broadcast will be repeated on Saturday morning on LA 36 beginning at 9 a.m. through 10:30 a.m. But again, welcome back to all of you who stayed with us throughout. And for those of you who found us via your clicker, stay with us. We've got some exciting music coming your way this evening. We kick things off up-tempo with two of the great giants, and frankly, in my humble opinion, two of the great unsung giants, namely woodwind artist, John Carter, and cornet player Bobby Bradford. This duo made remarkable music over the course of many, many years. And this particular tune entitled, great title, Sticks and Stones. This comes from a compilation of tunes that they recorded back in the late 60s into the early 1970s. This was recorded at Occidental College, believe it or not, back in 1969. Comes from the Complete Revelation Sessions. Bobby Bradford, John Carter, working with Tom Williamson on bass and Bruss Freeman on drums, stoking the fire as only he could. John Carter, clarinetist, very few peers on that horn. Frankly, very few peers on all of the woodwind instruments that he specialized in. Played tenor, played clarinet, flute. And this particular compilation features the great John Carter on all those instruments. And of course, Bobby Bradford, great cornet player. These gentlemen have some things in common with a gentleman I'm going to feature later on as part of our video selections this evening. This is a special evening because, as always, I try to do each and every semester, I invite back a very special gentleman who worked with the gentleman we opened up our program with, John Carter and Bobby Bradford. Not only did he work with these guys, he's worked with everybody in the business, practically, among other things. He's going to bring you up to date, as a matter of fact, on some of the things he's involved in, some of the projects. He is currently playing baritone saxophone in a renowned orchestra that I'll let him talk about briefly. He is the conductor of a very, very special orchestra that holds forth out at Cal State LA. As a matter of fact, next month they're going to have a concert working with a vocalist of renown. Stay tuned. I'm so pleased and proud to invite back my friend, Mr. Charles Owens.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here, Chet. It's always a pleasure, man.
Like I always tell you, Charlie, the semester isn't complete unless you're here at least once.
It feels good to be here. It feels like I'm at home away from home.
Yes, sir. I love it. Love it. Charlie is going to not only bring all of you up to date on some of the things he's involved in, but also he brought in his band. He's going to play a little bit for you a little later on.
Hey.
First things first, Charlie, let's bring folks up to date. I know that when you were with us last semester, right, you were in the process of retiring from both jobs, one at UCLA and the other out at UCI. So that process is complete, right?
Absolutely. That's the best thing I've ever done.
Now you've got some time to breathe, huh?
Yeah, and practice.
Ooh, and practice.
Yes.
You notice, folks, this guy's been playing for a number of years, and he still practices on a regular basis.
I have to. I'm beginning to feel like I can play him a little bit now. It's only been 55 years.
Only 55 years. He's 56, by the way, so he's been playing since he was a pup. I mentioned, Charlie, that you are currently a member and have been for quite a while, a member of a renowned orchestra headed up by the gentleman who runs a jazz studies program out at UCLA, Mr. Kenny Burrell. Talk about that particular band.
Okay, well, he has a big band, and we play once a month at Catalina's. Mm-hmm. He wants to establish something like Wynton Marsalis has back east, like a concert band that plays different styles of music mm-hmm. by different composers. And he is very dedicated and sincere about that, because he's a very busy man, and he finds time to rehearse the band, mm-hmm. get charts together, have Bobby Rodriguez as a contractor, so he calls up everybody, and it's sounding better every time. We're going to play on April Fool's Day at Catalina.
April 1st.
That's no joke.
But okay.
The band is really, really good. I get a chance to play some baritone.
Right.
And I played baritone with the Duke Ellington Orchestra under the direction of Mercer Ellington.
Right.
And we got a Grammy on Digital Duke.
Digital Duke.
Yeah.
That's a classic date. Yeah.
It sure is. Yeah. We had a lot of great musicians there. But getting back to Kenny, he's very, very good man to be around. Mm-hmm. Very inspirational. And he played a solo on I Got It Bad and That Ain't Good the other week, and man, it was emotional.
Very, very special. In addition to your work with that particular band, Charlie, you continue to head up the Luckman Jazz Orchestra at our sister campus, Cal State LA. And next month you have a concert coming up where
yes.
the band is going to be working with a pretty good vocalist. Talk a little bit about that.
Well, we've had a couple of vocalists already this year. The first one was Barbara Morrison. Mm-hmm. She's such a lovely lady, and she helps everybody in the community, and she has a nice place at 5506 East Degnan Street down in Leimert Park, yeah. where she features different people. And we wanted to do something to help her since she had an operation. And
right.
But she's singing better than ever.
How about that?
You know, she's singing better than ever, and yeah. she's just a doll. And then next we had Carmen Lindy, who is a great individual-like stylist.
Mm-hmm.
You can't pigeonhole her. She's just a straight-ahead jazz musician that can play all of the instruments. And our next concert on April 13th will feature Diane Shore.
No, not Diane Shore.
Oh, excuse me, Diane Reed.
Okay.
I'm going to get sued, I guess.
No, not really.
That would really be a difference, wouldn't it? But anyway, we're going to have Diane Reed, and we're very excited about
yeah.
having the opportunity
yeah.
to interact with her, and we've gotten two of the arrangements already from her musical director, who is Peter Martin,
right.
and they're in Europe right now, mm-hmm. and they'll be getting back around the 1st of April, something like that.
Yeah.
So I'm very excited about having the opportunity to work with her, because I remember when she used to be coached by Phil Moore. When she was just starting out, we did a concert over at Marla Gibbs,
mm-hmm.
featured all of his students. And she was one of them, and she was cool then.
Wow.
And then she came out and to one of Kenny Burrell's fundraisers at UCLA, and she was hanging out and making eyes at the musicians. So she likes to hang, you know.
Oh, yeah.
So she's a real jazz spirit. So I'm very excited about getting a chance to work with her, because she's special.
Indeed. Folks, if you have never taken the time or taken the opportunity to head out and hear the Luckman Orchestra at the Luckman Auditorium on the campus of Cal State LA, I strongly recommend that you look into going out on April 13th. It's a Saturday evening. They hit at 8 p.m. The Luckman Jazz Orchestra, under the leadership of my very special guest, Mr. Charles Owens, and they're going to be backing the one, the only, Miss Diane Reeves. That's going to be something special.
Absolutely.
Something very, very special.
Thank you.
You mentioned, Charlie, Barbara Morrison's Performing Arts Center in Leimert Park. A little later on in the program, I have an announcement to make about a certain band that's going to be playing there next week. And I would hope that I see all of you out there, if for no other reason, just to say hello, but to also clearly listen to some wonderful music. Charlie, we opened with Bobby Bradford, John Carter, both of whom you worked with very, very closely.
Absolutely.
What comes to mind about these great, great musicians, particularly John Carter, in as much as both of you are woodwind masters?
Genius, a trendsetter, stylist, unwavering in his commitment, because I knew John very, very well. We had a music studio together, and his studio would be next to mine, and I'd hear him playing all this unbelievable stuff, just warming up. I performed. Just warming up. You know, okay. He started off where everybody else left off. Mm. I say, John, why don't you play some Bye Bye Blackbird so people could know what you're talking about? Wouldn't think of it. He played all his own compositions. Mm-hmm. He always played them in the key that he heard them in. Uncompromising, just like Thelonious Monk.
Yes.
He would not compromise. He's just a wonderful player. He would practice at his lunch. When he was at school, he'd take his clarinet with him,
yeah,
and had his sandwich and stuff, and then practice, because I'd just go have an occasion to go over and talk to him about, mm-hmm, something, because when James Newton formed his woodwind quintet, I was a member of it, and I would go over and talk to John about the music, and we'd discuss, is the same pitch in Europe as it is in America? I thought it would be the same pitch, and it is, but it's a little higher in Europe, I think. And they would wear me out, but I'd take my tuner and say, this is A. Okay. This is A in hell, blankety, blankety, blank. I ain't changing.
Give everybody a time frame. When are we talking about?
Probably about 1981 to maybe 89.
Okay.
Because that's when the Wynn College was working, and that's when I was playing with the Duke Ellington Orchestra. I played baritone with that band. But
right.
That's about the time frame. And
how did the Wynn College come together, Charlie?
Thank you for asking. That's a very good story. Well, Stevie Wonder had a CD or record, or album at that time, mm-hmm, called The Wonderful World of Plants or something
Secret
like that.
Secret Life of Plants.
Secret Life,
yes,
of Plants.
Yes, yes.
And I played oboe and English horn in that orchestra, and Red Callender played tuba. So James Newton was looking for a tuba player to do some recording with when he was going to do his quintet album, mm-hmm, which is tuba, bassoon, clarinet, oboe, and flute. And James said, we were friends, we were going to Cal State LA. He said, Charles, I need a tuba player. I don't want to have to bring out Bob Stewart because the airfare is so much. I said, you don't have to look any further. All you have to do is call up Red Callender. He could make the tuba sound like a French horn, and just made it sound so melodic and beautiful. You know, it didn't sound like one of those Dixieland tuba players, just boom, 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 which is not bad for that style, but Red could just make it sing. So James called him up, Red consented to be on the CD, and they fell in love. I mean, it became like a friendship, because John and James Newton were friends from quite a few years before, because James had been playing with John Carter, and John tucked him under his wing and told him, you know, maybe helped him develop. So I was kind of like a halfway friend with Red, and we just kind of fell in love with each other, and then we formed the school together because we loved, you know, hanging out and playing together.
Oh, man.
Played out the Comeback Inn a lot of times.
Ah, the Comeback Inn. Boy, that brings back a few memories. My goodness. John Carter, Bobby Bradford, and this next gentleman have something in common that you mentioned to me before we began. They hail from the same state, literally almost the same neighborhood, if you will. Back in 1966, a gentleman took his trio to Paris, France, to do some recording, to appear at a couple of clubs. But his primary reason for going to Paris was to essentially lay down the soundtrack for a movie. That movie was entitled Who's Crazy? The band, drummer Charles Moffett, bassist David Eisenzahn, and the other gentleman in the band, somebody of note, Mr. Ornette Coleman. We're going to show a brief clip of that band in Paris, literally watching the movie unfold. Remember the title, Who's Crazy? And they're laying down the soundtrack as they are observing this movie. So check this out.
You're on. Thank you. sure that that's our best take of that.
This is what I really would love to have in my music, presence, you know, as long as I can live. I mean, I don't care about nothing I played yesterday if I can go home right now and write some music that is a presence, you know. That's why they have machines, you know. So you can, if you want the past, there's a machine that's got the past right there, you know, and which I think is very good, you know. So therefore, that means we as human beings can be in the present.
I'm playing to communicate with the audience. We're all playing to communicate with the audience, right? But underneath it all, there's a kind of a devilish thing of, I could do something tonight that will get to Ornette and Moffat. And we all have that thing. It's a musical one-upsmanship.
Some people do not really hear Ornette's music. They may be there, but they're really not listening. If they come, they may be listening for something they want to hear. And when it's not done, they don't accept it. I don't care who it is. But if you like listen to Ornette, if you can throw everything out and listen to really what's been said, they may get the message.
In right here as the trio leaves Paris after laying down that soundtrack to the movie Who's Crazy? Ornette Coleman, of course, multi-instrumentalist, playing alto saxophone, of course, a little bit of violin, a little bit of trumpet, bassist David Eisenzahn, and the drummer Mr. Charles Moffat. Some of you out there may remember a date that was cut in the mid-60s, a couple of albums at the time, Ornette Coleman Trio at the Golden Circle. That's the band that performed there back in the mid-60s. My guest, Mr. Charlie Owens, is to my left. It's always a great pleasure for me to have Charlie in studio with me. Charlie, I mentioned before we played this clip that John Carter, Bobby Bradford, Ornette Coleman have several things in common. You want to talk about that?
Well, the first thing is they're all from Dallas, Texas.
Okay, fundamental stuff.
Absolutely all from Dallas, Texas.
Right.
And they all... stretch the boundaries of jazz.
Exactly.
Know. Went a little further than bebop. And we're very, very melodic and very original. Yeah. Those are two things. I can't think of anything else. But I love this last tape that you just showed, because I always learn something when I come on your program.
Yeah, it's a pleasure.
Wonderful.
But you said something important. They stretched the boundaries.
Yes.
They threw out some elements that were fundamental and added others.
Didn't play chord changes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just made it up on the spot.
And a lot of people dismissed what they were doing at the time, but heck, you go to any club these days, and this is pretty tame stuff compared to...
Yep.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah, yeah. But it's still, again, like you said, stretch the boundary, open things up.
Mm-hmm.
I guess you could call it, in some sense, so-called free jazz, free expression. Some labeled it, here we go with labels, the avant-garde. Nevertheless, this music continues to evolve.
I think so.
And the three gentlemen, John Carter, Bobby Bradford, Ornette Coleman, Don Cherry,
right,
Billy Higgins, of course, they were right there as mm-hmm. the music was evolving over time.
Right.
Great,
absolutely.
Great stuff. Yeah. Charlie Owens is here. I mentioned a little earlier that the Luckman Jazz Orchestra is going to be working on April 13th at the Luckman Auditorium on the campus of Cal State LA. Check your local listings, folks. Get out there and check out this wonderful orchestra backing one of the best vocalists in the business, Miss Diane Reeves. What I'm going to do is share a little Diane Reeves in concert not too long ago. Some of you who are familiar with the jazz people here in Southern California will recognize a few of the people working with Diane Reeves. And then when we come back, I'm going to turn the Charles Owens Quartet loose, and we're going to have some fun. So, Charlie, as always, man, it's wonderful having
you
here, man. And great stories. And if you ever need someone, you know, one thing I didn't mention, by the way, Charlie continues to be involved in bringing the music to the kids.
Right.
Yeah, could you talk briefly about that, Charlie?
Well, I retired from teaching.
But I mean in terms of the band and going to the elementary schools.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
I had the pleasure of doing 15 concerts at 15 different schools, elementary schools, during Black History Month to introduce jazz to young people.
Yeah.
And everywhere we went, the kids loved it. Mm-hmm. You know, we had to know how to talk to them, how to keep them under control, and put up your two fingers, that means be quiet. Sometimes they do it, but it's always planting the seed of jazz, because we must have played for about 5,000 kids, and there are three bands playing, doing the same thing, two besides myself.
Right.
And it's always a pleasure and a privilege to go around and talk about Louis Armstrong and Duke Ellington and play A-Train and mm-hmm. introduce the kids to Ella Fitzgerald and Pink Panther, tell them they already know something about jazz and play that melody, and they all know Pink Panther. Just play the vamp, and they say, oh, the hands go up. So it's, I'll be doing it next February too. Been doing it about
How many years now?
Oh, about 10 or 11.
Oh, yeah.
And it's always the same personnel.
Sure.
Donald Dean, mm-hmm. Luan Lowe, John Bell's a guy, and this year we brought in a new trumpet player, Dr. James Ford. He works out at the school, so it's really, like I say, a privilege to go around to the schools, do two assemblies at each one, and plant the seed of jazz, and make a little money too, so it's cool.
So you're still educating. Even though you retired from UCLA and UCI, you're still out there educating these young people.
Well, that's what I try to do at my gigs too.
Yes.
Draw people into what I'm doing, and they'll enjoy it, and perhaps they will come back. If they don't like it, then they're not gonna come back, so it's, you have to touch people and give them something to take home and send them home with a smile.
All right. And very quickly in that regard, before we play the Diane Reeves number for you, mark your calendar again next Wednesday, a week from tomorrow, that's March 27th. Charles and his quartet will be at Barbara Morrison's Performing Arts Center in the heart of Leimert Park. I think the address is 4305 Degnan Boulevard in the heart of Leimert Park, one block east of Crenshaw Boulevard on 43rd Street. They hit at 8, they go till about 10:30, and some of the swingingest music you'll ever hear in your life. So again, Charles Owens, the band, Barbara Morrison's Performing Arts Center, next Wednesday the 27th, 8 p.m. start.
And it's safe to come over there, but when you come, be sure to bring some change, because the meters work until 12 o'clock at night.
That's important. Last thing you need is a ticket.
That's right.
You ticket it in the heart of the Leimert Park. Diane Reeves, working with her small band, and then we'll come back and I'm gonna turn Charles and the guys loose. Enjoy this Diane Reeves performance.
Without a noise, without my pride, I reach out from and the grand facade so soon will burn. Without a noise, without my pride, I reach out from the inside. Oh yeah, in your eyes, life can be, and complete in your eyes, I see the glory. To a thousand churches, your eyes, the resolution, all my fruitless searches.
Fellas, we're going to hold off. I'm going to introduce these guys in just a moment, but you've been watching Diane Reeves in concert. This was recorded back in 2000, the year 2000, at the Montreal Jazz Festival. Of course, it featured the wonderful vocalist Diane Reeves out front, and she'll be featured with the Luckman Jazz Orchestra again April 13th at the Luckman Auditorium on the campus of Cal State LA. And they start at 8 p.m. And the orchestra under the leadership of Mr. Charles Owens. Speaking of Charles Owens, Charlie brought his band in, as he usually does, and I'm just going to turn these cats loose and introduce them after they play this first tune, and then let them rock the house a little bit more. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, this is the Charles Owens Quartet playing a Jimmy Heath line entitled Gemini.
Thank you.
Charles Owens Quartet playing a Jimmy Heath line entitled Gemini. Some of you who are longtime jazz fans familiar with that tune. Probably Cannonball Adderley and his band's interpretation of that wonderful, wonderful composition. Before I introduce the cast and band, I do want to mention, I'd be remiss if I didn't share with you in the video clip we featured Diane Reeves. I definitely want to mention the people working with Diane Reeves at the time. Odmaro Ruiz at the piano, Reginald Veal on bass, Roscoe Bryant on drums, and LA's own Munyongo Jackson playing percussion. The tune, a Peter Gabriel line entitled In Your Eyes, Miss Diane Reeves. Who are the cats in this wonderful quartet who have graced this little room on several occasions in the past? The leader, Mr. Charles Owens, playing flute in this case. Charlie. All righty. At the keyboard, Mr. Mikhail Majid, who plays in and around town. Mr. One Man Band himself. On guitar, Mr. Steve Cotter. And the house drummer, and has been for a number of years, the great Don Littleton.
Right.
On drums. That's the great quartet. I'm going to turn it loose. Go ahead, fellas. Floor is yours.
Thank you.
Charles Owens Quartet. That's an original composition written by my very special guest, Mr. Charles Owens, named for his grandson, the name of the tune, Che. Charlie on flute, Mikhail Majid at the keyboard, Steve Cotter on guitar, Don Littleton on drums. We are here live from the campus of Cal State Dominguez Hills as the band continues. Thank you. the Charles Owens Quartet transformed into the Chitlin Circuit Quartet for your listening pleasure. Of course, that's an Eddie Harris line entitled Sham Time. Charlie Owens out front on soprano saxophone and doing a little Rahsaan Roland Kirk bit with the tenor and the soprano simultaneously. Mikhail Majid at the keyboard, Steve Cotter on guitar, Don Littleton on drums. You are tuned to Jazz in the Modern Era. I'm Chet Hanley. We are emanating from the campus of Cal State Dominguez Hills over LA 36 and the internet. We're going to carry on. So much music, so little time. We're going to let the band continue. It's all yours, gentlemen. Thank you. The Charles Owens Quartet playing another Jimmy Heath line entitled No End. Charlie, of course, out front on soprano saxophone. Mikhail Majid at the keyboard. Steve Carter on guitar. Don Littleton on drums. Don, again, the house drummer for jazz in the modern era. Just a note, please mark your calendar a week from tomorrow, March 27th. Head over to the Barbara Morrison Performing Arts Center in the heart of Leimert Park, 4305 Degnan Boulevard to be exact, and more specifically, Suite 101. The same wonderful band will be entertaining. And you got to hear this music live, folks. Here, listening to it on television is one thing, but seeing them live is a whole different experience. So strong recommendation, check it out. We are going to close, or at least I'm going to close, by introducing this next tune. It's a Freddie Hubbard composition entitled Thermo. I want to thank all of you for tuning in again. We've had a ball here. I appreciate all of you who continue to follow us this particular semester, students as well, clearly. You got a project that's due very soon, so get busy. And again, if you need any more assistance, please give me a call. And at this stage in the game, you know all my contact information, so I leave it at that. Thank you, gentlemen, as always, for coming out and joining us. Had a ball. And close it out with a little Freddie Hubbard line. Have a great rest of the week, folks. We'll see you next Tuesday with another special guest. Mm-hmm.